This is Lightning. She's new. From the looks of it, I'd say the clevis is on the other side of this thing. I can't think of anything else that would be so heavily sealed. Seems like a regular crux won't cut it this time. We'll need something extra special. I guess it's back to the hunt for us.
Can you tell me anything about this?
Let me see. Well, I can tell you with certainty that it's old. That's obvious enough. Yet it's made with advanced technology, and its purpose is a complete mystery. It doesn't appear to operate independently. It must need other parts in order to work.
Who cares what it does? Just take it already. Have you forgotten you're a bandit now? It's your funeral!
Challenge accepted.
hope you'll get further in next time so we can get a better picture.
And we meet again.
Light, you should head back to the ruins and find your way to the galleries where the murals are.
Doesn't even begin to describe his recipes.
My secret recipe. So, did you try my new nectar?
Yes, it really did.
Ah, that is wonderful news.
Except the effect wore off too quickly. It has to last longer to be really useful.
A simple matter. For the purposes of the experiment, I deliberately reduced the potency, in case of side effects, you see. It will be the work of mere seconds to mix a more concentrated and potent version. I'm sorry to keep you waiting. This latest iteration I have named Miracle Nectar. Drink it to soothe your soul and restore your psyche, meaning it will free you from curses, leaving you mentally prepared to face any foe.
I don't believe you.
I forget that you are a mere layperson and need things spelled out. On that occasion, I was referring to the goal of my research. Now I am presenting the results. Anyway, do try it. From the looks of it, I'd say the clevis is on the other side of this thing. I can't think of anything else that would be so heavily sealed. Seems like a regular crux won't cut it this time. We'll need something extra special. I guess it's back to the hunt for us. From the looks of it, seems like a regular. We'll need something.
can't break the seal with brute force. I'd say this is a shortcut out of the ruins. Good to know if you need to get back to the desert fast. Since you went to the trouble of unsealing the door, why don't you follow the path and see exactly where it leads?
You got this?
You've nearly reached one of the galleries. You should find a mural of the gods there. Be on guard, though.
A good bandit always is, right?
Lightning strikes.
Now, I don't want to sound like I'm complaining, but I don't see any kind of mural around here. What's the story?
How disappointing. This is certainly the spot, but it seems that you'll have to activate the mural before we can view it. The device is missing a key component. You need certain ancient artifacts, known as tablets, if you found them.
We already have. You mean the ones from the shrines, right? We picked those up already.
Oh yeah, that's right. And so this is where they were meant to be used.
Saved us some trouble.
All right then, impress me. After all this, these murals better blow me away. We used to have this old rhyme, you know. Come, pity poor Etro, she was left all alone. Her blood pouring forth in chaos to atone. Queen of nothing, goddess of death, so let her be known.
And then Lindsay, in his wisdom, used the blood that flowed from Etro to give birth to the first humans.
Yeah, so we could do his dirty work. Among my people, Lindsay was known as a trickster, never to be trusted. Though, in the end, even our own god was no different. Pulse used us and threw us away all the same.
Yeah, I think we've all learned not to trust the gods.
At least it gave me the chance to meet you all. But then, after hundreds more years in Crystal, we wake up again. And for what? So Vanil can go mad listening to the cries of the dead? The gods want to make us pawns. But Vanil and me, we're done playing their games. It needs to stop.
Vanil and Fang. They once supported Cocoon in their crystal sleep, frozen forever in time. But why did they awake now, at the end of everything? What purpose could God have in doing such a thing? What sort of plan does he have up his sleeve?
That's a piece of a crux, right? What is this? All we get is some rubbish. Really?
It's no rubbish. It's the crux to the Sacred Gate, or at least one piece of it. All you have to do is gather all the pieces and put them together.
So, two more to go, right? Three seems to be our favorite number.
You've got all the tablets, right? Go around to each of the galleries. You should be able to see all three murals now.
I challenge you.
You made it all the way here, did ya?
Hiya!
holding up half the world when we were in that pillar. We saved humanity. Not like it's something I can break.
Think you can take us?
No, not even that. There's no amount of atonement that will ever make right all the deaths we caused, all the lives that we destroyed. I know Vanille worries about that too. She wants to make up for it, and she believes with all her heart that she can. But I don't think it's something that you can make up for, or erase. What's done is done, but she won't accept that.
You've made it pretty far in, haven't you?
Have an unusual aura about you. I sense that you have overcome great trials in your life.
I'll take that as a compliment.
I'm sorry. My intentions are pure. It's just that I see you must be a formidable warrior, and I am in need of one such.
Tell me about it.
My name is Nolan. There is said to be a beast. A beast with frightful power beyond anything before seen. I am quite certain now. Its existence is linked to the ending of this world.
And you want me to fight it, is that it?
Indeed. You are as intelligent as I thought. This is my theory. When the balance is tipped, and this world is finally swallowed by the chaos, that is when the beast will attain its true physical form, inspiring fear and despair in all who see it.
A monster that only appears when the world ends.
Indeed. In the past few days, I've seen a dramatic change in the data. According to my calculations, which are based on my hypothesis, the monster may have already manifested.
You have proof it even exists?
I know that it has appeared at least once before in this world. I've found records that suggest it appeared 500 years ago, the day that time stopped and the world was broken.
So what happened after it appeared?
It only achieved physical form for a very brief time.
Because the world didn't end back then?
That is my theory. All indications are that the world is truly ending this time. The data is clear on that. I want you to prove that my theory is correct.
Why worry about one monster now?
There is a corollary to my theory. I believe that this beast comes from outside of this broken dimension. Unlike those of us living here, its body has not been affected by the warping of our time. There is something I wish to test, and I will need a sample of its flesh to do so. So what do you say? Will you hunt down the extra-dimensional beast for the sake of science?
An enemy that is not of this world. Right. I think I can handle that.
Oh. So you will help me?
I might as well.
I am confident that you will be able to hunt down the beast.
Got it.
Here is all the research data I have about the beast.
Yeah, I'll do whatever I can.
There is not much time left until the end of the world.
Yeah.
Don't let your guard down.
Hey, Lightning. You feeling this? The air's different in here. I think we're close. We have to be. This heavy, cold atmosphere. It's got to be the power. Let's see the second mural. I paid for this show, and I want to get my money's worth. Hey, Lightning. What do you make of this, then?
It's the story of the gods. Or rather, the story of us. It shows how humanity was born from blood spilled by the goddess Etro. But we weren't made to live forever like this. We were put on the world to serve the gods, do their bidding, and then die.
But then the chaos broke through and changed the rules. Everything went pear-shaped, and suddenly it's like dying became an option. We became immortal, or that's how it felt at first.
You stopped aging the moment the chaos came, but misfortune and disease could still kill you.
And we don't multiply and fill the land anymore. No one's been born in centuries. You know, I always thought that death wasn't the end of us. Like our souls wouldn't disappear with our last breaths. They'd never really die. They'd come back. That's why I was never afraid to die for something I believed in. But now, I don't know. Dying feels like the end of the line. Like there's no hope of being reborn. Our souls will just get lost in the chaos forever. No second chances. I guess that's what Vanille wants to put a stop to. She figures this is her chance to save those lost souls. Some gear or something moved.
Let's go ahead and check it out.
The souls of the dead, crying out in their despair. No one else can see or hear them, so it's hard to appreciate what that would feel like. Do you think that Vanille is hearing the wishes of the dead? Is she hearing all of their regrets and desires?
We got the second piece. Let's go find the third.
You don't have to tell me.
You've got all the tablets, right? Go around to each of the galleries. You should be able to see all three murals now.
What a waste of time.
I saw this coming.
claiming this spot is mine to dig.
I'd say this is a shortcut out of the ruins. Good to know if you need to get back to the desert. Since you went to the trouble of unsealing the door, why don't you follow the path and see...
The Holy Clavis should be on the other side of that door.
I always dreamed of becoming a bandit.
If it looks dicey...
Where are the goods? Let's find them.
Watch out for chaos infusions!
The last mural, huh? And we can finally reach the Clevis. If it isn't the man himself, the Order's idol, Benevelza, god of light. Death defiles the soul. Let salvation purify you. So the dead are unclean, is that what they think? And when Vanille performs the soul song, those bastards are going to make everything neat and tidy again.
What do you mean?
Don't you know? It's the ceremony that the Order's got planned. It's the reason they want the Holy Clevis. So Vanille can do their dirty work. Thing is, she's the only one who can hear the dead.
And the Clavis can draw the souls of the dead. Isn't that how it goes? So what does the ceremony do? More than just summon the dead, I take it?
If you believe the Order, it's all putting the dead to rest and providing a salve for their tortured souls. That was enough for Vanille. Hook, line, and sinker. She says that she has to go through with the ceremony. She wants to atone for the past.
So it's what Vanille wants, this ceremony. But even knowing that, you have no intention of helping the Order?
Not in this lifetime.
The Order wishes for the soul song to be performed. A rite that they claim will purify the souls of the dead. If it might save the souls of those who have died since the fall, you should be lending your support.
Right, this should complete the crux.
Let's try it on the sacred gate.
Come on, the Clevis waits.
Should open the sacred gate. You've almost made it to the Holy Clavis itself. But be careful. The Order has mobilized its seculars. They may be on your heels.
If we get this open, we'll be face to face with the Clavis at last.
And who knows what else? I wouldn't be letting your guard down just yet.
Like I need reminding. How long do you think I've been out here in the desert?
I'm picking up a huge energy source from within the sacred gate. It's just like Fang said, the Clavis lies before you. It's close. It may have further protections, though. Be careful out there, Light.
We finally made it.
Yeah, we've gone and done it. No way to go but forward now.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Let's do this. So that's the Holy Clavis, the magic box that'll bring together all the souls of the dead. Damn, can you feel that? It's like some kind of force pushing down on my chest.
There's no question. That artifact is definitely emitting powerful energy. No human could have made this. Not without divine help. Either that or the gods themselves made it.
Hope, fill us in. What's happening?
It's the Seculars. They're close, and they're armed. I'm sorry. They must have been hiding in the chaos.
It's fine. Forget about it. Fang, it looks like Seculars have already...
Sorry about this, Vanille.
Fang! What are you doing? This is what you've been looking for.
I'm not letting anyone else have it. If Vanille uses this damn thing, she'll die.
What do you mean?
Damn this thing! It's a bloody curse! Yeah, purify the dead. Put them to their eternal rest. All it'll take is the life of a saint. Vanille is dead set on going through with it. She'll martyr herself to the past and then... You bastards want to take it from me?
No!
You have done an admirable job. The Sacred One will doubtless be pleased. Allow us to thank you on her behalf. Get the Holy Clavis!
You call her the Sacred One, but you're the ones who want her to die! That ceremony is not gonna happen!
Hear this, heathen! You insult the Order of Salvation, and in doing so, you blaspheme our almighty God! God's judgment be upon you! May you repent with your death!
Don't get your hands on the clevis over my dead body! So light, you wanna lend me a hand?
You're asking now? Let's do it, Fang!
Don't get in my way.
Took the clavis.
Bastards! Won't open. They must have sealed it. Damn it!
We're not getting through that way. The sooner you accept it, the better. What's the deal with the clavis? What does it really do? Doesn't it ease the dead's suffering?
Oh, it eases it all right. See, they get Vanille to summon the souls from out of the chaos with the clavis, then destroy them. No more soul, no more suffering.
They're just gonna destroy them all? Does Vanille understand what she's doing?
She knows it. Just like she knows it'll kill her. And she just goes on saying she's gotta do it. She says it's the only way to stop the cries she hears. The only way to save them.
And you didn't want to let her die like that. So you tried to get the Clavis yourself?
Yeah, that was the plan. I was looking for it, all right, but not to give it to her. To keep it from her, I knew what would happen if the Order got it. Vanille would kill herself for a lie. So I joined up the bandits here and watched over the ruins. And as long as no one found it, I could leave well enough alone. Now you see why I came along with you? I had to make sure that the Savior wouldn't hand the Clavis over to the Order. I didn't even trust an old friend like you.
That's low. You even doubted your old pal Lightning, spying on her like she was gonna stab you in the back. But I guess it's not so different from the way I spied on you. I had to wait forever to tip those guys off.
You? You're the one who led the Secutors to us?
Exactly. And without Hope even noticing a thing. Now the Order has their little Clavis and they're beating a trail back to Luxerian. I can't wait to see that ceremony, can you? All those useless souls purified forever in return for Vanille's life. Even the soul that was once Sarah, wiped away like it never existed.
When does the ceremony take place?
It'll happen on the last day of the world. When the final bells start to toll across the land, Vanille will face the Clavis and begin the soul song.
Fang, Vanille is going to die.
You never did mince words.
And I can't save her.
So, what's your point?
I save souls by granting them what they wish for. If Vanille wishes for death with all her heart, then I have to let her have it. I have no choice.
You're saying you'd let her die?
Yes, if she doesn't change her mind. I can't do it for her. You are the only one who knows how she feels. The only one who can save her from her darkness. You always have been.
All right. I get it. I get it, Vanille. You hear me? We're in this together. Until the very end. I learned about the Soul Song, the real truth of it, back when I was with the Order in Luxerian. They wanted us to think it was this great thing, gonna save the dead. But then I learned that it would kill Vanille.
Why didn't you try to run away together?
I wanted to. Believe me, I tried reason, guilt, even brute force. But Vanille, well, she wouldn't give an inch. She said she was going to do it, whether it killed her or not. This is still about her trying to atone for the past. Even the power she has to hear the dead, she thinks it's God trying to punish her. It's been real, Lightning. But now, it's time to go our separate ways.
Got it. Hey, next time I'm in the desert...
You won't see me. The gang's officially disbanded. I've got somewhere else I need to be.
Sounds like we have a date in Luxerian. Good luck, Fang. See you at the end of the world.
on, everybody. Do enjoy our glittering city, dear visitors. The song of the Savior will be performed again. I need not. Sprinkle Palmer's delicious food cheers everyone up.
It's really wild here at night.
Poor souls who gather in Yusan, hear my voice.
So I tried your latest concoction.
That is most gratifying to hear. Then the name was well chosen, miraculously. The miracle nectar works. I have succeeded, but I cannot rest on my laurels. I shall give you another task that is something of a diversion. In science, sometimes you must step off the path of pure research and hack into the jungle of commerce.
What are you talking about? A diversion? You're starting to lose me with your metaphors.
My research requires expenditures, flasks, Bunsen burners, liability insurance, etc. I need new revenue streams.
You want me to help you make money, is that right?
Bluntly put, but in essence, yes. Exactly. I want you to be a spokesperson for my latest product. This is the concoction that you previously tested. I'm rebranding it as the Nectar of the Gods. Catchy, don't you think? It's yours for free, and I can even offer a guarantee.
What do you want me to do with it exactly? You already know it works, so you don't need me to just test it, do you?
I want you to participate in the battle arena. Then, in battle, you must drink the nectar in front of the entire crowd. If all those people see how well it works for you,
then they'll come flocking to buy their own.
Exactly. They'll see you drink the potion and think that it will make them as beautiful and powerful as you. Oh, how they'll be clamoring to give me their gill.
And it's all for the sake of science, right?
Science? What do you... Ah, yes. Yes, of course, for science. That goes without saying.